Unique content is something we all strive to do in 2021. And one thing is unique content, but also creating SEO optimized content can be quite difficult without the right tools at hand. Today's product showcase can help you with exactly that. Today's product showcase is LongShot, and LongShot is a GPT-3 tool, which means it's an AI tool which can help you go from nothing through the research phase and then in the end ending up with an article which is SEO optimized. Basically, LongShot AI is an all-in-one blogging tool that helps you create high-quality content. So without further ado, let's dive into LongShot.ai and let me show you how you do it. Signing into LongShot, this is basically where everything begins. This is the dashboard, you can say, but it is basically just an overview of your blogs. Up here, we can create multiple projects if we want. I would like to see that I could make maybe folder structure within my projects, because otherwise I would have to create a project for each article, and you will see later why. We have the different modules out here, the blog module, which is basically all of these modules combined, but it is just if you want to just create a fast headline, if you want to do a rephraser, a text extender, FAQ, or the blog insights, you can also do that without having to create an entire blog. Let's try and create the first blog post in here. You can see in the menu out here, we do first have the research, the headline, the outline, and then the blog in the end. So let's start out with a topic. This is our keyword that we are going to focus on for this article. Our keyword is going to be internal link building WordPress, as we see right here. Now, as you can see here, I entered a long tail keyword because this is often how we create articles. But here it's actually asking me to choose a shorter topic. So I will delete WordPress again in order for us to be able to continue, but I would like to see them being able to handle long tail keywords in the near future. Here there are some small design things. However, let's press search and see what results we'll get within LongShot.ai. You can now see that we have multiple elements based on our keyword up here. We have the top keyword relevant for our keyword. Then we have similar keywords. It didn't find any. Then we have top questions where it's pulling data from Quora, Google, and Reddit. The last down here is we can see some search volume over the different months. And then we have the definition here, which it cannot find any data on either. However, what we need to choose now is that we need to choose the keywords we want to focus on, and we need to choose the questions we want to add to our article. So I will just choose some keywords here. And as you can see, when I choose keywords over here, it is adding those keywords. So I will just choose some keywords. And now you can see as a little thing here, when I add more keywords than the field can contain, then again, there is some design issues. But as I mentioned, it is not a refined tool. They are still work in progress, of course. If I do want more keywords, that is also possible to load more here. But I have chosen some keywords now. And what I'm going to do is I'm also going to choose some questions that I want to answer in my article. And I'm just clicking on it. It looks like nothing is happening, but it's because they're just adding in the bottom here. Now we need to choose our headline style, whether it should be how to, descriptive, or listicle. For this case, I will do how to because it is how you do internal link building. And then we'll generate some headlines. And as you can see here, this is where we use credits. So here we'll say we'll approximately use 1.5 credits in order to generate headlines for my article. It has now generated headlines, as you can see here, using the data as we just saw before with the keywords and the different questions. What we have to remember here is that this is the headline, an H1, which means that it's the headline for our blog. It's not an outline, it is one headline that we need to choose. I really like the first one because it's very descriptive. However, I will just remove the last part here. So I will choose the headline, how to use internal link building to improve your Google rankings. And we'll now move on to our outline. See here right now, I have some saved outlines that I have done earlier. However, over here, you can see that we have the questions and the keywords that we chose in the first step, but we now have to create our own outlining. We can, of course, click up here, and then you can see we got an outline here on two headlines. However, it is not so relevant and it's not so many headlines. I would like to see at least five, maybe six. So I'll just add some headlines here. There are still some minor UX things here. When I'm adding headlines, it's not deleting the text that it sets in per default. Could be a nice thing. However, I have now added some headings and we now have an outline. So we'll now generate and start improving our blog. So what's going to happen now is that it's going to generate the blog post that we need to work on. And as you can see, it did it right here. So we have our H1 up here, how to use internal link building to improve your Google rankings. Then it has done an introduction, even though I added introduction down here, another introduction, which is very similar to the one up here. And then our headings here, our conclusion and FAQ. As you can see, the text added here is very limited. I would like to see it add way more text to the different sections. However, I will show you just in a moment how you do this. What I would like to see here is that I often add an FAQ to my articles. And as you saw in the research point, the first menu point, we could choose a lot of questions and I want to be able to answer those. However, I cannot answer all of those in my article. So it would be cool if I could add all of those questions in the FAQ section down here. It could be a small add-on which could really help me stand out in the search results, because rich snippets is something that's really blowing up right now on Google. However, we now have our article here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to click in my introduction up here, do a space, and then I'm going to say write more. As you can see right here where it's saying generating text here, it's now going to replace this with the text that it is generating for me. So you can see it is now generating text. Google is a powerful search engine, and it is also highly advanced when it comes to interpreting your website and so on. So this is how you build out your article. It can be that you need to write some text in between, but otherwise you can basically just click write more on all of the sections until you have the length of the article that you need. Furthermore, if we want to make a new section down here, we can also use the unstuck me, where it is that based on a keyword, it will then write a new section for us. So in the unstuck me up here, I will just choose increases search, and then I'll say generate. And now based on those keywords, it is now generating text for me. And this is just a great way to actually unstuck me if I'm stuck writing and I don't know what to write about. We have the similar keywords up here that we can write content about. The last one I want to show you is the synopsis. So what I can do is that I can click on wherever I want my synopsis and then click on it. And what it's going to do now is it's going to generate a synopsis for the article that we have generated now here. So you can see it's basically going to sum everything up and just write it down here for you. This is the main functionality of the editor. Out here you can see the performance, how many power words we're using, the readability, how complex it is to read. Right now it is fairly complex to read. We do not want that. We want it to be very easy to read. We can see the amount of word counts and the keywords that we should use out here. We're only using one of the keywords right here, so we should use linking internally, rocket science maybe, increases search, but it needs to be relevant for the article, of course. In the end, I can either just save it up here or I can export it. However, if I press export, as you're going to see here, it is just going to download a Word file. I would like to see some functionality where I could integrate it to WordPress or to whatever website system I'm using in order to just do this way more seamlessly, because it would really help me speed up the entire process. Because right now it is so fast to come to the point where it is that I've generated the article. However, from there now it is a bit frustrating that I have to copy and paste everything into my WordPress website. Moving on, the different modules out here is basically what we just saw, but this is just if we want something very isolated for a very specific need and we don't want to create an entire blog article for it. So what we can do here is that we can just choose our brand name. For this case, I will just choose IKEA. And then we need to choose some keywords. For IKEA, it could be furniture. And you can see here, we also need to choose a select style. I just chose how to. And then I added some keywords, furniture, tables, chairs. Out here, we will now get a lot of headlines that we can use. Of course, it's up to ourselves whether we want to use it as our blog headline or we want to use it in our outlining, because it is also possible. You can see here there are different types of ideas, how to buy furniture, how to survive your next dinner party with IKEA's table, how to spot fake IKEA furniture, and so on. So this is just ways that you can generate headlines fast, and you can save them out here, or you can generate similar to this. So if you like this one, but you want a little twist on it, we can just regenerate and get something similar to it. We can also give feedback. When it is that you save headlines, they will lay in here. However, again, I only have one project here, so it will become very messy. I would like to see again a folder structure where within that folder structure I can have my different headlines. Moving on to the rephraser, this is basically the same view as we just saw before. We have our text here, how to measure a table before buying it. We will just use this text and press generate. So you can see it has now rephrased my text very little. It is almost the same. The only thing that has changed is at IKEA instead of in IKEA. There are other examples where it does it very well, but this is just to show you. Moving on to the text extender. This one is very, very cool. If you have a lot of text, it is basically like the write more function, which I just showed you, but this is where you extend your text, basically. So you have a text that you want to add more to, but you don't know exactly what you can add. You can write in a sentence here, and then you can press generate, and you will get a longer sentence. I have now entered a text, and then we can choose whether we want a short or long generation. I'll just choose long and press generate. As you can see here, it has now generated some text, and often when I use this tool, I do get very good results. It is a very impressive tool, and as you can see here, this is also a decent result, where it's talking about Amazon as a competitor, being the reason why people are not selling so much on Instagram shopping, and so on. A really great tool, and I can really recommend this tool personally. Now moving on to the FAQ module, this is a bit useless for me right now, and let me explain why. When it is that you work with FAQs within your blog, you want it to be relevant for Google. However, the FAQ module isolated here is just generating text. It is not pulling data from Quora, Google, or Reddit. It is just generating text. So all of these questions here, even though they seem great, they are just generated, so just be aware of that, because you want to spend your time on relevant questions which people are asking and not so much just generated text. I would like to see that they use the blog FAQ module in here as well, and I would like them to see integrating people also ask in the system, because it could really add some value. The last one down here, blog insights, is where you can write an entire article. I will show you just in a moment. And with that article, it will just pinpoint what is important within this article. So there's an example here, digital marketing, where it has written an entire article here. And when I press generate here, it is going to pinpoint the most important things of this article. This is basically like TLDR, too long didn't read, where you can get the entire article just boiled down to maybe 4, 5, 6 different insights that are important for you in order to understand the article. As you can see here, it is showing a lot of percentage, a lot of numbers, a lot of years, because that's what's important within the different articles. This was the example within longshot.ai, so of course this is working great. However, if I use my own article, then you can see the results here. I have entered my entire article. I would like to see an import feature where I can import my articles to get an insight module where I can just showcase the different elements of my article in a TLDR. However, it is not working very well. This article is about internal link building, and I'm mentioning rank math SEO some places, but not that much that it requires for this blog insights module to show 3 blog insights only within the entire article. And this is a long article. I would like to see this one adding maybe 5, 6, even 8 blog insights, but it is only showing 3, and they're not so relevant for this article. So this is a bit mixed results. Taking a look at the pricing structure of longshot.ai, they do have 3 plans, and everything within longshot.ai is built on top of credits, which means that every time you generate content or you just use their FAQ module or whatever you do within the tool, you use credits. With the 3 plans, you can get started completely free. That's the first plan, where you do have 10 credits a day that you can just use on whatever you want. If you do want more, they have their mid-tier plan, which comes in at $30, where you do get 1,000 credits, and that will take you very far. That's a lot of credits within the system. And as you just saw, often you use 1, 2, maybe 3 credits to generate some content. The last one of their plans is their unlimited plan, where they do have unlimited credits, of course. This one costs $110, which is a bit pricey when you take a look at the competitors. However, you do get more modules. I will talk about the competitors just in a minute. When I tested out the tools, I did need the support. I did have some questions, especially about their FAQ module, whether it was pulling data from Google or it was just generated content. And the response was great. They answered me within a day, actually within an hour. So that was very, very good. Taking a look at the competitors, I see it as Closest Copy and Neural Text. Closest Copy is not a direct competitor. However, their long form editor is similar to longshot.ai. They do both create very good content. They generate great content. However, Closest Copy do not have all of these blog modules. As you just saw, using Longshot, we can use their FAQ module. They even have a conclusion module. This is not possible within closed copy. The other competitor, Neural Text, I see as a very close competitor to Longshot.ai. However, based on my testing, as you can see in the review up here, they didn't perform so well, the content generated was not so well, and the overall research phase I was not very satisfied with, compared to Longshot.ai, who really goes far, and you do get very good results using Longshot.ai. Now, who is this tool for? Because the tool is not refined, as you saw, it's still a new tool, and it does still need a lot of work to become an enterprise tool, even though it's not the plan for now. However, it does have its uniqueness in the modules combined together, and the way that you create an article is really great. I do recommend it to marketeers, or if you're running a blog, or even if you have a product, like a SaaS product, because you can use it for industry articles. That's what I have tested it for. And within the industry articles, it's doing great because it can really research all of the data out there and utilize and use it in the articles. Whereas if you have a news site or you're an enterprise site, I wouldn't recommend you using it because everything within the tool, all the facts, everything is not checked. So if you're a huge company who has a lot of credibility, maybe this is not the tool for you. However, if you are a marketeer or you do have clients you create content for, industry articles is where Longshot.ai really excels. What I really do like about Longshot.ai, and I have really missed in other tools, is that they're very focused on the content side. They just want to be your SEO tool when it comes to content. They want to be your go-to tool in order to create SEO optimized content. Taking a look at the future of Longshot.ai, they do focus on fixing bugs in the near future and optimizing their entire blog module because that's what you use the most. This is where you create the article. Furthermore, they're working on creating a separate blog intro module. I do hope, however, they integrate it in the blog process because that's what I use the most. Of course, it is great to have all of these modules separate in the menu, but I would like to see it integrated when it is that I create a blog or an article. Furthermore, they're adding multi-users, which means that you can invite all of your colleagues to work with you within Longshot.ai. This will definitely be a more enterprise solution. Furthermore, they're improving their blog insights and they're adding more data and more functionality within this. All of these are what we'll see in the near future. If we do look further ahead, they're adding two add-ons, a fact checker and a tones add-on. A fact checker basically means that when it is that you create content, all of the facts where it's talking about percentages or year, it is checking that those facts are correct. This is definitely something that would make it more appealing for enterprise companies or at least bigger companies that we can be sure that the articles we create within Longshot.ai are fact-checked. And the tones add-on just means that we can create different types of articles where we just change the tone a bit, whether it's for social media or it is for still our blog. Using Longshot, I have definitely been able to create multiple industry posts because that's what I have used Longshot for. It basically takes me 30 minutes to go from nothing to have an article that is ready to be published. However, 30 minutes, it is not an article which are going to rank number one. It does require more time. But if I just want an article out, which I can refine later on, then Longshot is such a great tool to do this. It is really exciting and it's such a great tool. And with the future ahead, I'm just hoping that they will keep sticking to the content side and just be the best tool to create these articles because so far they are really doing great. So yeah, that's my review of Longshot.ai, a great AI tool to create SEO optimized content. I hope that you liked the video and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions about Longshot.ai or other products you would like me to review, please leave a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Let's catch up on the next one.